President Buhari go visit London after in Saudi Arabia waka. And governors now they meet for inside Abuja to talk on the payment of money where government been give states. And a police inspector, plus including one other person, 9 kidnappers don't carry for FCT community again. Joint body of medical directors now don't call Ogwenge government, say make them celebrate Stella at Dadevo. Good evening and welcome to Azobia Max TV. This is now as it take happen. My name is Adate Onwukwe. On top of the first story where beside CARICOM, President Muhammadu Buhari now go waka go United Kingdom for private visit, and after that one, he go attend the Future Investment Initiative, will be FII for Riyadh for inside Saudi Arabia. Special advisor to the president on top media and publicity, Oga Femi Adesina. Now, he talk this one for inside One Talk paper on Monday. In Yansi ACB, he said the private visit now will last from 2nd November, go reach 17th of November 2019. And the talk paper see Yansi President Buhari go yarn with King Salman and King Abdullah II of Jordan. And after the yarn finish, he go enter United Kingdom on Saturday, will be 2nd November 2019. And ACB go return enter Nigeria on the 17th of November 2019. For inside the second tour, the 36 state governors now, under the umbrella of Nigerian Governors Forum, they do meeting for inside Abuja. And according to the program of the meeting, the governors now go discuss how they go take pay back the 614 billion naira bailout money where Ogbonge government been give states. This one, as sake of the notice where BC Ogbonge government don't been give states to collect the money. And according to the things where BC them get to talk for the meeting, the governors go talk about updates on deductions for budget support facilities from the right organ of government. And as it be, then go still talk about the things where BC they want do to get money where state government supposed collect, plus including matter of tax, collection of grand rent, entail, mtel, and other things. The people where BC show face for inside the meeting, now chairman of the forum and Ekiti State Governor will be Dr. Kayode Fayemi, in deputy, and the governor of Sokoto State, Aminu Tambuwal. Other governors where BC show face for inside the meeting, now governor of Ondo State, Imo, Oyo, Cross River, Benue, Kaduna, Zamfara, Anambra, and Osun State. Now this one, Nana go carry us come out, enter the next to read in hand. As joint body of medical directors now and medical practitioners, don't they tell Ogbonge government to say, I beg may they try to celebrate the late Dr. Stella at Dadevo, sake of say she been helped to stop Ebola virus for inside 2014, make it for no spread. Then been they had this one on Sunday for inside the remembrance and thanksgiving service to honor Dr. Dadevo inside First Baptist Church for inside Abuja. President of the joint body, Dr. Femi Babalola, now in talk, say make Ogbonge government now declare one day as public holiday, make them call that one national honor to take remember her.
Of Ebola spread across Sierra Leone for months. Hundreds died. I can imagine what would have happened if that diplomat had found his way into the, you know, to the general populace, or if he had been admitted in a public hospital rather than a private hospital, where maybe they were not as they may not have been as aware or proactive as they were in the first consultant hospital where Dr. Adedevo worked in those days. Speaking on behalf of the Guild of Medical Directors, all private practitioners in the country, we are calling on government, we are urging government to do something in memory of Dr. Adadevo. Name something after her, give a holiday in her name, something, anything, to ensure that her memory is not lost.
Even as I still in yam for there, one right activist, whether they call talk person, Peter Nkanga, he come out and tell government to say, may then try to teach the good work where BC Dr. Adadevo been do for inside the school, for the things where BC they teach for different schools where they for inside the country.
as I'm talking to you right now, university students, I was at BUK, and I was asking students there, do you know that the third ever is, who is that? This is just five years ago. 10 years from now, 20 years from now, nobody might remember her. And that is why we are fighting that she should be given the national honors in accordance with the National Honors Act of 1964. As I'm talking to you right now, university students, I was at BUK, and I was asking students there, do you know that the third ever is, who is that? This is just five years ago. 10 years from now, 20 years from now, nobody might remember her. And that is why we are fighting that she should be given the national honors in accordance with the National Honors Act of 1964.
Still for Inside the Matter, Senior Pastor of First Baptist Church, Israel Akanji, he talks as if he's to say that no fit forget the good work where she been doing.
She died in the service to our nation. She died for the protection of the lives of others. She disallowed that Ebola victim from traveling out of her hospital, and he will have affected so many people and many lives. Because of her, we had it contained to the level it was. And so our prayer is that the government of Nigeria will see heroism in what this woman has done and establish something in her memory so that people will be true compatriots in Nigeria.
And for Inside the Next Story, African Union Department for Trade and Industry, they don't talk plenty about the need for countries where BC they be member to put necessary effort for industrialization so that then go fit address the different wahala where BC the economy gets and to jack up industrial development inside the continent. These are some of the things where BC then talk about for inside the workshop where the department's been organized. Where BC the main thing are to assess the money where BC they need to put for industrialization agenda. And as it be so, Chief Technical Advisor to the AU Department of Trade and Industry, Webi Rongai Shizema, he talks that industrialization are the key to rearrange the tori of Africa and to position the continent for economic development. In particular, Likon, they talk about the importance of Nigeria for the industrialization process, and he said the country gets a big part to play for the process.
And we're so happy that we've been able to leverage our own human capital, our own resources in the continent, to unpack the African debate on how we can leverage our resources to better fund, sustain the program. Because we have everything here. In Africa, 95% of everything you see on a car, we can produce it here. The 5% can be done somewhere else. So why are we not having a vibrant auto value chain development?
And one of the people where BCD for inside the workshop now, Dr. Carl Oshodi. And she talks to make them consider small and medium scale businesses them so that them too they go follow for inside the process.
So on financing industrialization in Africa, we are looking at particularly how the informal sector can also reap the benefits of industrialization in Africa. Part of this focus is on the SMEs. So also look at some of the tools that are necessary. Is it on policy, government policy, and how the private sector can leverage on this policy to benefit particularly the informal sector that are driven by women and youths.
This workshop where BCD and Duna part of all the plenty things where BCD don't talk with for inside meeting with the stakeholders that now people where BCD get mouth for the matter to develop waiting then go use put money for African industrialization agenda. And we sharply come out from inside that to re-enter the FCT. As people where BCD they live for inside the FCT now don't they vex give government. Sick of say them never put mouth on top of matter, we consign them. Especially the people where BCD they live for small towns where they close to Abuja. Then they talk plenty give FCT administration, sake of say them no get better transportation system where BC fit carry the population where they rise every day. Our Tory person John Emmanuel now get more Tory for this one.
Most of the people where they live for areas where they outside the city center say then they find them very difficult to go work or their business places because they either hurt them to get motor, we go transport them go where they want go. They can't follow the yarn and the para say this matter of lack of proper transportation system for Abuja and a shameful thing because why capital city like Abuja no go get standard transport system like other capital cities of this world can get. The one way can't even they pay them pass now the way where Abuja Urban Mass Transit Company when are them supposed to provide buses to carry people from one place to the other does die like that.
The reason why there's not enough motor here this time around. They are taking four in Cairo. Very soon, the bus will be available very soon. Now we say the population plays the part. Most of the bus are in headquarter. Most of the bus break down. They never repair. They're under repair. Very soon, the Obamas will get right over there.
They can't even ask questions. See, I didn't say the manager Abuja Urban Mass Transport Company well. Say, people wait there for this city. Nobody suffer the way they suffer for transportation matter.
This is a very bad scenario. In a situation where you have an appointment and to get a vehicle is becoming a very big pothole. So we feel that the government should do something on this issue.
To get transport, at least I'll be here for more than 30 minutes looking for vehicle that will take me to where I'm going, central area. It's been hard for me to get it. They hard.
We know they get motor. Formerly, motor they wait for people. But now, motor no they wait for people. These Obamas are trying their best. But now, we don't know about the system of this government. Whether or not they sponsor Obamas, I don't know. So people are suffering. Look at the population. It's not easy.
Actually, they live for areas like Nyanya, Kuvua, Karu, Gwagwalada, Lugbe, Buari, and other places. They not be small suffer than they see before they get motor to come work or their various places of business. According by them, now private vehicle owners, them they depend on to feed move from one place to another, especially in the morning where people they rush to go to work. As if that one never do, most of the people say then they stand for like 3 to 5 hours before they fit see urban mass transportation bus or any other government motor. They come to say this one, they make them go work very late and tired even to come back. Now so that they come back home very late and tired as well. Now so they come carry cry, they beg the FCT minister, Mala Mohammed Bello, say I beg, say make him try for his second tenure, make him provide enough mass transit buses to make life better for country people so that everywhere go jolly.
They should find somewhere to widen the road for us. May they give us a line whereby it can contain everybody on the road.
My name is John Ada Emmanuel, reporting for Wazobia Max Television.
And for inside another story where BC One resembles that one. As part of the efforts now where BC the one used to reduce the wahala with passengers this face, sake of the boundary between Abuja and Nasarawa State, one religious organization now don't carry the matter put for head to fix road with day around one area. Pastor of Dunamis Church or inside the Maraba one will be Bartholomew Oche. He may explain say the work where BC then they do now part of the better work where BC then supposed do for Nigeria. And as it be so, in Consi talk say if them complete the road where BC then they do, where BC don't bad now for over 20 years. Say it go reduce the plenty wahala where people they face, especially people where BC they live for Maraba area.
Officials flag off of the construction of the road, the boundary road leading from the junction to Dunamis, and this road is named after Dunamis, and it is part of our corporate social responsibility, giving it back to the community.
For inside this one, maybe say the church don't do now. One of the road users now can't come out, can't they hail the church, sake of the good work where they just do.
This road has remained unconstructed. So it is a great joy that today Dunamis Commission is about taking the responsibility of constructing this road.
It has been a very bad experience for us road users to our car, and we have been permanent customers to mechanic because of this road. We're coming back from work every day, getting to this junction. I feel very, very, very frustrated on how to get to my road, but beautifully, and as God will have it, at the commencement of this road construction, I feel very happy, and I pray God gives us the strength to conclude it.
For inside the next story, we no sweet belle at all. One police inspector will be serving, and another person will be say be named Bamundi. Now we hear say kidnappers don't carry for inside Rubochi community for Kuje Area Council, where they for Abuja. Kidnappers been carried the two people on Sunday, 48 hours after the bad gang been carried the younger brother to former chairman of Kuje Area Council, maybe Muhammad Galadima. And they answer that for inside the same community, now in this one they happen. Nancy talks say plenty kidnappers now enter inside the community for midnight, come they shoot anyhow. And as the matter be, the deputy talk-talk person of the FCT command, Mariam Yusuf, he don't give promise, say, as he be, say they go provide details of this one where be say it just happened. And when they come back with business story, make you no go anywhere. And for inside the business, upon the plenty talk where BC country people they talk for the border where BC don't they close now, CBN governor will be Godwin Emefiele. On Monday, he don't list out the things where BC supposed they ground before they go reopen the border. Oga Emefiele talks in Nigerian borders they closed and it will remain like that until neighboring countries now do go agree to apply anti-smuggling policies them. And as a young give State House to read people after the meeting with President Muhammadu Buhari for presidential villa for inside Abuja before the president been go Saudi Arabia. The CBN Oga talk say the border where we say they close don't reduce all the many wuru style where we say they use bringing things for inside we country and say now this one don't help to improve rice production for we country. According by your guy Emefiele, he talks apart from the reduction of for rice smuggling, say poultry farmers now don't benefit from the border where they close. As the bee say they don't sell their markets since illegal importation no been green them to sell their markets. And when they come back with sports, no go anywhere. And for inside sports now, Enyimba nine don boost their chance to make them for the group stage of the CAF Confederation Cup after them beat CS Galaxy of South Africa 2-0 for inside the first leg where we say them play for Enyimba Stadium for Aba on Sunday. Enyimba now 9 they lead for inside the 7th minute through Victor Mboma where we say Nain's call as Abdulrahman Bashiru been set the ball for Ram. And then Martin Usele, now he can score the second goal. And we stick on here, say TS Galaxy being tried their luck, but Enyimba goalkeeper will be Theophilus Afelokai, no being let him to shine. And we see here, say as the matter be, then go play the return leg next week for inside South Africa. And the overall winner now nine go enter the group stage of the Confederation Cup. Now all the Tori PDs, but before we go, make we still look all our top Tori them again. President Buhari go visit London after him Saudi Arabia waka. Governors now they meet for Abuja to talk on the payment of money where governments give states. And police inspector and one other person, nine kidnappers don't carry for FCT community again. Joint body of medical directors don't call on Ubunge government to make them celebrate Stella at Dadevo. Now all the Tori be this as it take happen. I make you still remember saying inside Wazobia Max TV is still there. My name now Adati Omupe. On a good evening.